Hello to you. My name is Maria Kąsielska and this is Poland Daily Culture. We're talking about movies and directors. And the person to talk about this topic, of course, the best one is Łukasz Jasina, who is with us on Skype. Thank you very much.
Happy again to hear from you. Welcome, everybody.
And I know that the director, Krzysztof Kieślowski, is one of your favorites. And the Decalogue is one of your favorite movies.
He is, but of course not the most favorite. He's one of the favorites. I couldn't feel different when I'm, let's say, a generation of Kieślowski. When you are a filmaholic, film fan, and you love movies, and you are raised in the 80s and 90s, you cannot don't like Kieślowski. Or you can only like him or hate him. And Kieślowski was an important film director not only in my film education, but also in the creating of my ethical system and creating the way I know the world and the way I feel on the world. It was a great thing that all those movies were screened exactly when I was someone who is searching, like a typical young man and a teenager. Kieślowski was like that all his life. We usually forget that Kieślowski died when he was 50 and 4. But he was a searching director all his life. When he was 20, firstly, he wasn't treated like a good candidate for a film director at the beginning of his education, but he became one. He later became a great documentary movies director. All his documentaries, my dear viewers, are worth to see. Officially, there were only movies on the socialist Poland, but they are so universal. And later, when he was 30, he tried to change his life into the fabulous features, and it's not so easy when you're a documentary man. But he was able to do this. All his great movies, like a Shame, like a Peace, like The Amateur, the movie on the man who is filming everybody, The Blind Accident, all those movies became great and put him into the elite of the Polish cinema. But there were also a few very sad years at the end of the 80s, broken by the Decalogue, when he was in the making of good and important movies. And after the Decalogue, there was a breakthrough because he received his passability from France and made 4 movies in Polish French co-productions, which made him the worldwide famous film director. But Kieślowski was not only famous film director. He was a searcher, as I said. He was a thinker. He was someone who giving us a guidelines, and also he was giving all those guidelines in a very modest way, not like all those great Viscontis, Bergmans, who behave like a gods and shows us the only possible and only acceptable version of the world. He was one of us who is a little bit cleverer than us and trying to give us a guideline. Yes, I still think after 32 years since I seen Kieślowski's movie first time in my life, that he's one of my favorite film directors and the one who need to be listened even 25 years after his death.
Also, he knew who to ask and cooperate with. And that's a person who, because the music in his movie, especially in The Double Life of Veronique, plays a very important role. And here comes a person of Zbigniew Preissner, a film music composer, one of the most important. And as I've seen The Double Life of Veronique, what I always remember is the scene, of course, when she's singing and dying is one of the Veroniques, but and that's the beauty and the genius part of Preissner. But Preissner wrote also music to the Decalogue. Yes,
of course. And Preissner is a very interesting composer and the person himself. He's not a musician by the education. He's a historian, but he also received some musical education. His debut was a weather forecast, the movie made in 1981 by Tony Krause, probably one of the saddest and greatest Polish movie made after the war about the escape of the people from elderly home during the winter of century. That's my another advice. Maybe we need to discuss this later. But Preissner music was full of melancholy, sadness, and at the same time, epical enough to illustrate Kieślowski's movie. And yes, speaking of Preisner and his music made as a soundtrack for Decalogue and later to the Trilogy of Colors and Double Life of Veronique is probably one of the most melancholic music ever made for the world cinema. The result of that was, of course, great career of Zbigniew Preisner as a composer. And there is also a music we need to listen if there is a possibility. But now, during the time of Spotify and YouTube, probably everything is there. Preisner, few months after death of Kieślowski, composed a special requiem dedicated to him, Requiem for a Friend. This big orchestral piece includes many motifs known from the Kieślowski's movies, but also is a special dedication. And let's say, if someone else would make a movie, if someone else would make a music for a Decalogue, probably it would be much worse, even if Poland is a country full of good music soundtrack composers.
And what I was surprised about is this part of the Requiem written by Zbigniew Preisner was used not only in La Grande Bellezza, also I would say a very romantic movie and with this element of sadness, but also in The Crown. So two pieces of film worldwide known from the Western world. And here we have the music of Zbigniew Preisner, the Polish composer.
Zbigniew Preisner is the third Polish film composer. We don't mention Jana Pekaczmarek, which is a little different situation after Wojciech Kilar and Krzysztof Penderecki, who composed so much for the Western movies and were put into the one of the most important pieces like that. Penderecki even bigger. But to be honest, that's a very good piece, very good music, and I think their place in the series like Crown is completely deserved.
I fully agree, and I'm very happy that the music at least can cross the borders. And of course, also films of Kieślowski are crossing the borders, since all of them, the one we've discussed, mostly Decalogue, but also Three Colors and The Double Life of Veronique, are translated and well received by an international audience all over the world.
Which was a shock for someone at the beginning of the 90s, because to be honest, even the greatest Polish filmmakers didn't think that such hermetic cinema made in Poland will be much more popular than historical dramas, will be much more popular than historical dramas by Wajda or Kawalerowicz. But it happened. It means world needs from Poles our heritage, which is also a spiritual heritage.
Well, I fully agree with this sentence. And Kieślowski proved this, that our spiritual heritage and the way of approaching also morality is maybe what we can offer the world, especially right now. So, Ten Commandments of Zbigniew Kieślowski and other of his, of Krzysztof Kieślowski and other of his movie and the Zbigniew Preisner music. All this absolutely amazing. And thank you very much for being with us.
Fine.
I'm watching Poland Daily Culture.